Why is this an important amendment, and what exactly would it do?
Yeah, sure. This is a real travesty, and protecting children should be our number one priority. So as you said, the House budget included language that I had filed to allow limited access to level one sex offender information. And the reason we need that access is because we know for a fact that level one sex offenders have committed almost every single crime that level two and three sex offenders have committed. So that means, and that includes, rape of a child, possession of child pornography, and just awful, heinous crimes against children. And yet, child care providers do not have access to level one sex offender information. And this all really came to light back in 2012 during the John Burbine case, who was a level one sex offender in Wakefield, and he had access to children through his wife's daycare and just committed horrible, heinous crimes against infants and toddlers. So we then found out that in Wakefield, there were 17 level one sex offenders registered. 16 of them had committed their crimes against children. We also found out that 65% of level sex offenders at that time had committed their crimes against children. So it's really imperative to have this information. Unfortunately, the Senate refused to include that language in their budget, so continues to let dangerous sex offenders hide their identities and prey upon children. So there's an opportunity right now. Senator Bruce Tarr has filed an amendment. It's number 921, and it mirrors the House language that was passed, so that every senator has the opportunity to stand up for children, to vote for this amendment, and to pass this language in the Senate budget.
And we're not talking about small numbers here. We're talking about roughly 2,700 people in Massachusetts that are classified as level one. That's not including level two and level three. That's just level one, 2,700 people. So there are a considerable number of people that we have concerns about who are offenders against children. And for some reason, the Senate just doesn't want to seem to, at least at this point, give access to that information to people who take care of the kids.